let's discuss the concept of excess pressure inside a bubble. If we talk about a soap bubble or a bubble made up of a liquid film, and say we consider the wall thickness of the bubble as very small compared to its radius. In this situation, again, due to surface tension, the liquid surface inside as well as outside on the soap bubble or the liquid bubble will have a tendency to contract. And due to which inside, say if there is a point A and outside there is a point B, obviously due to this contracting tendency, pressure at A will be more than pressure at B. And at some point when the bubble will be in equilibrium, we can say the excess pressure inside is balanced by the force of the surface tension. Like what we have discussed in the case of excess pressure inside a liquid drop. Here also, to analyze this excess pressure, we divide the bubble in two hemispherical sections. And here you can see, if I just draw a hemispherical section, it will look like this. This is the hemispherical film of the soap bubble or the liquid bubble. And in this situation, we can say the right part will exert a force on it in outward direction due to excess pressure. And this outward force can be simply written as excess pressure multiplied by the surface area, which is pi r squared, that is the area of this hemispherical base, which is pi r squared. And on the two circumferences in inward direction, surface tension will exert a force, that is T into 2 pi r. And on both the surfaces, it will be T into 2 pi r. And we can take the radius of the two surfaces to be r as the film thickness or wall thickness of the soap bubble can be considered to be very small. So in this situation, we can say for equilibrium of hemispherical section of the bubble, we can use, in this situation, it is excess pressure multiplied by pi r squared, that is outward force must be balanced by twice of T into 2 pi r. In this situation, pi and r gets cancelled out, so, and excess pressure can be written as 4T by R. This is exactly double that of the excess pressure inside a liquid drop, because here there are two liquid surfaces, whereas in case of a drop, only outer surface exists. That's why the excess pressure in a soap bubble or a liquid bubble is double than that of the liquid drop of same radius made up of same solution. So just be careful about this expression of excess pressure inside a bubble.